If you haven't seen the previous episodes, make sure you watch them in order so everything makes sense.
Hey, it's me, Jane, again. And to be honest, I still can't explain what happened last time. Every time I close my eyes, I can still see Samantha falling down. Samantha, who was smiling just several hours ago. Samantha, who wanted to go into sports and help people. And now she's in the hospital, and it's all my fault. After that accident, I was sent home for several weeks for distant learning. The principal told my mother that if she didn't want me arrested, she should keep me under lock and key. The principal also said that I wasn't allowed to go to school. People seemed to think that I was trying to hurt her on purpose. My classmates were supposed to send me homework, but they stopped talking to me. They ignored my emails and DMs, too. Even if they did read my messages, they would never answer. My mom had to call all their moms, but they were also not going to help me. They said she ought to discipline me better. So I spent the second week at home. Now I don't even have homework, school, or Samantha to keep me company, because she also began to ignore me. So what do I have to live for now? All I have now is sitting, staring at something, and eating. I can't even watch our favorite movie without wanting to throw up. My mother also doesn't want to speak to me. I think she feels sorry, or maybe she's just angry. I feel like I live in some kind of vacuum, like an alternate reality, or like a terrible nightmare. Just what's the point of living if it's going to be like this? The only good thing that's happened was that the dream stopped. Maybe I finally managed to make myself so exhausted. Maybe I finally cracked. My whole life was thrown out of balance. I had just started to come to terms with my new reality with these dreams. Then the world shifted again. Now I'm trapped like a disgusting rat in my own home. And then, once again, something weird happened the other night. I had a dream. I saw the mall about a mile away from our house. I saw a fire blazing. I saw people trying to escape, but the doors were locked. People were suffocating and dying left and right. The scene was terrible. I woke up in a sweat. That means, oh God, the dreams were back. It seems like the fates decided my life wasn't bad enough yet. After waking up, I tried to erase the dream out of my mind, but it was so damn vivid. I ran out of patience and asked my mom if I could go out for a walk. Strangely, she let me go. She just forbade me to go to school and said that I had to avoid my classmates, who were honestly still quite hostile towards me. That was easy enough to agree with my mom because I didn't plan to go to school or see my classmates. All I needed to do was visit the mall and warn everyone to evacuate as fast as possible. I walked towards the mall, brooding. The accident with Samantha clearly showed me how distrustful people could be, so I had to figure out an exact and clear explanation. I reached the mall and saw, even at this early hour, that it was packed. I started to approach security personnel to warn them about the fire, but I freaked out. What would he do right now, even knowing that there could be an accident? So I changed my mind. I approached him and asked him to take me instead to the administration. He looked at me with surprise, and then he laughed and told me that little girls should just go shopping. What could someone like me need from management? I tried to explain that I enjoyed shopping in one of the mall stores, but the salesperson was in breach of mall policy and behaved rather rudely to me. That's why I wanted to make a complaint. The guard just smirked and said, "Sorry, little miss. That's something you ought to take up with that store's manager. Ain't got nothing to do with me." I insisted that he should take me to the mall administration. He was sick enough of bickering with me and asked me to leave him alone because he had to go back to work. But I wasn't about to give up so easily. I decided to speak to the women who were sitting at reception. I told them about an accident that would happen at the mall today. They responded to the words of such a small girl in a way I expected. They just laughed and asked me what was so terrible that might happen. I told them that there would be a fire. I said that I heard a conversation between two guys standing not too far from the mall and talking about arson. The reception girls thawed a little bit, looked at each other, and then laughed even more. They called me a fibber and asked me to leave. I can't believe everyone in this godforsaken town is so reckless and checks nothing. Anything could happen. Nothing is finite. Life can be snatched away in a single moment, even yours. A wave of anger was tearing me apart. I wanted to scream for everyone to pay attention to me, for everyone to realize what was going on, for everyone to run away, escape. I was standing in the middle of the first floor looking around. Happy people were shopping, laughing, playing with their kids, not a care in the world. I couldn't believe that they're going to die today. I couldn't let it happen. I was the only one who knew the truth. I was the only one who could prevent the accident. I needed to overcome my fear, let my anger fuel my adrenaline. So I took a risk. I hopped up on a table and screamed to the whole mall that the people needed to get out of that place, that there's a fire inside the building and it would collapse soon. It worked, to some degree. People began to run out of the building. Not all of them heeded my words, though, but it did seem like a lot of kids left, so that was good at least. But I kept screaming. The guard I had spoke to earlier immediately grabbed me and pulled me towards the exit, but I didn't stop. Some people from the top floors looked at me as though I was mad, which is, you know, honestly true. They thought I was freaking out or playing a really bad joke. The guard dragged me to the door and said, "Calm down, now! You can't just scream fire in a building! Do you understand me? Who the hell do you think you are, punk? Tell me your name so I know what to tell the effing police!" I got scared. "Please, please believe me. I didn't want anything bad. Just trust me. There will be a fire today, here at the mall. A lot of people are going to die. I just don't want that to happen. Just ask people to leave the mall and keep it empty for the rest of the day. You can call the police in case nothing happens, but if..." He sharply interrupted me. "What fire? What the hell are you talking about? How could you know that? Either you're an arson, insane, or more likely you're just a little girl who has nothing to do and likes attention. You think freaking people out is just a little game, huh? You think that these stores are gonna close for no mother effing reason? You should have kept silent and went home. The police won't treat you nearly as nicely as I am now, girly." What was I supposed to do? It was getting dark, evening was near, and just like in my dream, the fire could start any minute. What was I supposed to do? I nodded at the guard, pretended to understand anything. Tears were streaming down my cheek. Then I began to go downstairs, as though I was going to go home. His eyes were following my every step. And then I looked back. He was entering the mall back to his original position. I realized that it was my last chance. It was now or never. I had to save those people, come what may. Suddenly, I heard an ear-splitting noise like something huge was bursting. I was standing on the last step of the stairs leading up to the mall when I saw the fire starting on the second floor. It was just like in my dream. Right away, people began running out of the mall, swearing and bumping into one another, and I was standing still, staring, unable to move. Again, I saw something that had already happened in my dream. People were running by, and I was getting rammed into like they were a herd of speeding animals, though I guess that is actually what they were. And the police were there in a flash, as well as an ambulance and the firefighters. The rescue operation had begun, and then someone took me aside. I think he was a different security officer, but I kept watching the mall burning to the ground. I saw people on the second and third floors trying to escape. At that moment, the guard I spoke to earlier went to the police and began telling them something, pointing at me. I just stood there and did nothing. There was nothing left I could do. Then I felt the police officer grab my shoulders and started to shake me. "Was it you who started the fire? Tell me now! You? Who helped you? Where are they? Come clean! You think you can get away with this? You think we won't take you to jail?" I felt like stone in his hands, shaking but not moving, not understanding what was going on. I felt the inevitability of everything happening around me. I guess I really can't change anything. Then I saw my mother, who was running to me as fast as she could. She grabbed me and also began to shake me, crying and saying that it wasn't my fault. I wasn't guilty. She said that she had forgiven me and even fell on her knees. I was still frozen, silently standing there. Everything happening around me seemed to be so surreal. The burning mall, the dying people, the desperate firefighters, even my mother, who was freaking out. Even the police officers who handcuffed me and took me to their car didn't feel real. They put me in the back of the police car and closed the door. The last time I looked out the window, I saw my mother in the fire. Then suddenly my vision became blurry, and warm, salty tears began streaming down my face. This moment would be etched in my mind for the rest of my life, and there was nothing I could do.
Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next episodes.